How about the goalkeeper position as we talk about capital? I mean, we don't know what happened to Zack Steffen. He did manage to hobble his way out there after this final whistle and celebrate with the team and celebrate with Ethan Horvath. And Horvath said, look, when I came on, we've been together since we were 14 with these national teams. Zack said, everybody trusts you. Just go do your thing. And he absolutely did. Does this, in your mind, Kalen, introduce a competition where there might not have been, at least outwardly looking in, a competition? It seemed like it was Zack Steffen's job, period. Now, look, if he's hurt, that's one thing. We don't want him to be hurt. Nobody does. I hope he's fine. I hope this is precautionary. I hope it's one of those things where he felt something and, you know, he just had to come out because he didn't know. But should there be a larger conversation about who the number one in this player pool is and the decisions that Greg has to make come World Cup qualifying?
I'm always okay with that type of conversation. I think that that's helpful. And you want to have competition for places. And we've seen what happens even where I'm like, yeah, Tyler Adams is unquestionably our best number six. Would I like to have a number six who stepped in his place and was like, wow, is Tyler Adams still the guy? Like, yeah, that'd be great. That'd be a really nice problem to have.
Then you're France. That's a problem France has.
Yeah, exactly. I would take that at a number of positions. But first of all, yeah, I don't know how serious the injury was. Not looked like a non-contact injury, which is troubling. I still think, for me, Zack Steffen is the number one pick for me. And a part of the reason for that is, look, I think he's a great shot stopper. He misread a chance. He misread a cross on a set piece in the Honduras match. For me, that's a little bit of a rhythm play where you kind of judge it wrong. But I think also when you look at even at this match, his ability to come off his line, I think he has a little bit more range than Horvath. I've seen Horvath make some fantastic saves. He's come off his line well. He took a couple in the face against Switzerland, but those are a little bit more like short rushes, where I've seen Zack command a little bit more, even when you watch him play with Man City, where he's able to really come off his box. Sometimes it might be a little bit scary, but that's part of the position for a modern goalkeeper, especially if the U.S. wants to play at times some of this pressing style that we've seen them employ against certain teams. And then also when you look at the difference with with the ball at his feet, I think that's a big mark for the way that Greg wants to play. Yes, we've gotten in trouble a couple times. Zack has found himself in some trouble as well as you know, some of our center backs, but that's going to be a part of the way the U.S. wants to play. And so I still would back Zack as number one, but man, I love what I'm seeing from Horvath. I mean, the kid, he's like an instant U.S. soccer legend from just that performance last night. And yeah, if I'm looking at potential injury or a World Cup qualifier or Zach's not ready to go, I mean, how good are you going to feel about looking at your quote unquote number two here and being saying, okay, yeah, he did it in this final. You can go wherever you need to go. We're going to feel good with you behind us in the back.
May not also be even the number two. If Matt Turner has a good Gold Cup and gets in there, I would say for me, Zack Steffen came into this week as the clear starter. He leaves this week as the starter, but it's not as clear. And so I think he lost a little ground over the course of this week and other guys gained it. The problem is everyone has a hole with what they're doing, right? There is no clear, obvious player. Ethan Horvath plays great. He's only played four games this year. He may not have a club right now. So those question marks for him exist away from the national team. And for Matt Turner, we haven't seen him play with the national team that often. So he has to prove he can do that, as well as there are question marks around where he'll be playing, which is not negative. It's a positive. But then he would also have to get wherever he goes and get time if he is going to leave the Revs this summer or whenever it is. So I think Steffen, it felt like, was in ink. And to me, now it's in pencil. He's the number one, but it's not as obvious and he doesn't have as strong a case. And then I'm going to get crayons out and start putting some other people in places.
So that is a good point on Horvath. It's a point on Steffen. He said it on this podcast. Look, I have to sit down with my agent and figure out what comes next for me, because he does want to be a number one. He does want to be the starter, but he is in an incredible environment with City. Now, the same goes for Horvath. He does need to have games. You don't want to be going into qualifying, and you said it there, Kalen, a little bit of rhythm. You don't want to have – those are moments that you can't afford in qualifying. That's just the way it goes. Like, those are the margins.
I mean, if Chas Sargent doesn't clear that off the line, we may not have been in that game yesterday.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, so, and we saw it in the FA Cup. You know,
Yeah, and that's part of the reason why a lot of these guys aren't coming back for the Gold Cup, right? Is so that they can sort out their club situations and they can make sure they're in a position to try and get first team minutes or get regular minutes, so they're prepared when World Cup qualifying starts. So you're sort of throwing everything at this one and then taking a break, letting other people emerge for Gold Cup, letting the European guys get settled into their teams, because these are still young goalkeepers. These are still young players for the most part across Europe. And, every over there, managers switch every 20 minutes. So, and you might be needing to find a new club. So I think it's a smart one. And look, if you're Horvath and you're trying to find maybe a move, or you're trying to get a place into a team, you had a pretty good stage to do that last night. So it's got to go well.
Yeah. Congratulations to him, as one crier to another. Good to see you let it all out, big man. Good to see that. Did you enjoy that? Was that right up your alley? Well, go subscribe to Extra Time wherever you listen to podcasts. You can also check the full shows on the MLS YouTube channel right over here, and you could subscribe to the MLS channel right here. Thanks for listening and watching, everybody.